In the last class, we discussed about the applied control of pest. So, in this class, we will start with the last topic, that is integrated pest management. So, what are these integrated pest management? What are the different steps taken in these integrated pest management to control the population of the insect pest? So, this integrated pest management is widely accepted and it is popular in nowadays as it shows a major impact on a insect pest control. So, this integrated pest management is broad-based approach to control the pests. So, integrated pest management is also called as the integrated pest control, and it is a broad-based approach that integrates a range of practices for economic control of pests. So, in these integrated pest management, they use a different practices. So, with the use of different practices, they will control the pest population. So, these integrated pest management is used or broadly in a nowadays to control the population of these pests and their causes to the crop field. So, through these implementation of these IPM, it will totally control the pest population. These IPM aims to suppress pest populations below the economic injury level. So, as we know, these if we do not take any care of these pest population, they may injure the whole economy by causing different diseases, by causing harm to the crop plants. So, the main aim of these IPM or integrated pest management is it will suppress the pest population below the economic injury level. So, in this way, these IPM play a major role in suppressing the pest population. The careful consideration of all available pest control techniques and subsequent integration of appropriate measures that discourage the development of pest population and keep pesticides reduce or minimize risks to human health and environment. So, these IPM, it consider some of the conditions before implementing these IPM in a crop field or in a environment. So, if we are willing to implement these IPM in an crop field, what are the different consideration should be there in this IPM? So, it should reduce the population of the pests, and it also reduce the use of the pesticides. Or through these, if we are willing to implement the integrated pest management in a crop field, it should show some of the characters, or it should show some of the measures. Those are, they should discourage the development of pest population and also should reduce the use of these pesticides. As we know, these pesticides may cause damage to the human health and also to the environment. So, if we are implementing these integrated pest management, these IPM should consider some of the measures. Those are, they should discourage the development of pest population and also should minimize the use of pesticide, as this pesticide may cause damage or they show many side effects to the human health and to the environment. So the careful consideration of all available pest control techniques and subsequent integration of appropriate measures that discourage the development of pest population and keep pesticides are reduce or minimize risk to the human health and environment. So the IPM emphasizes the growth of healthy crop with the least possible disruption to the agro ecosystem and encourages natural pest control mechanism. So these IPM, it mainly emphasize on the healthy crop growth, and these IPM, its main aim is to give a healthy crop and should show least disruption to the agro ecosystem. So through the implementation, if we are implementing these IPM in an crop field or in an environment, it should give a good growth of the crops and it should not cause any damage or should not disrupt the agro ecosystem. And also these IPM, its main goal or aim is to encourage the natural pest control mechanism. So without the use of any pesticides or chemicals, the pest population should be reduced or should be suppressed and give a good growth of the crops. So these are the main goal of these IPM. So these IPM emphasizes the growth of healthy crop with the least possible disruption to the agro ecosystems and encourages natural pest control mechanisms. So ee hengenga time change aakkota hogtada hangangeno antandre every individuals they are preferring the organic farming or they are preferring the natural pest control mechanism. So if we are alive eno antandre jaasti enadru pesticides anna naavu crop field alli implement maartta hodvi antandre so these pesticides they are showing a risk to a human health and also to the environment. So ee vandu problem in the eno antandre nowadays people are preferring the organic farming. Through these organic farming we can reduce the environment pollution and also to the health issues from the crop field or through the pest. So these IPM main goal is to give a good growth of the crops and also should not disrupt the agro ecosystem and it encourages the natural pest control mechanisms. Then IPM allows for a safer means of controlling pests. So if we are aiming to control the population of the pest, these IPM, it will suggest the safer means of controlling pests. Then IPM is used in agriculture, horticulture, human habitations and preventive conservation. So these IPM is used popularly in agricultural, horticultural, human habitations and preventive conservation. So in this field, these IPM is oftenly used and IPM will suggest some of the main goals or some of the main principle to reduce the population of this pest. Then principles, what are the principles involved in the integrated pest management. Totally, there are 6 basic components in this principle according to the American Integrated Pest Management System. So, those are, first one, that is acceptable pest level. So, the emphasis is on control, not eradication. IPM holds the wiping out an entire pest population is often impossible and attempt can be expensive and environmentally unsafe. The IPM programs first work to establish acceptable pest levels called the action thresholds. So, acceptable pest level up to some extent we can control the insect pest population. After that, we completely cannot eradicate these insect pest from a crop field or an environment. If we are hoping to eradicate or kill the insect pest population, it will be impossible and it will be expensive and also it will be unsafe to the environment. So these IPM programs, their main goal is to control the pest population up to some level, up to acceptable level we can control these pest population. After that, we cannot eradicate completely from the environment. So, up to some extent, we can control these pest population through implementing some of the methods. So, this is about the acceptable pest level. So, the main emphasis is on the control, not on the eradication. So, even the acceptable pest level, main goal is up to some level vargu enu antandre insect pest population anna control madodu enu antandre main irutha. So in these IPM, they emphasize on a control, not on the complete eradication of this pest population. So second one, that is preventive cultural practices. Selecting varieties best for local growing conditions and maintaining healthy crops is the first line of defense, together with the plant quarantine and cultural techniques such as the crop sanitization. So, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಪ್ರಿವೆಂಟಿವ್ ಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸಸ್ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಇವಾಗ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪನ್ನು ಗ್ರೋ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೀರಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ that the cultivating crop or a cultivating condition should be proper, and we should select some of the varieties which are best for the field, and we should select some of the resistant varieties, or we should fumigate the seeds before sowing the seeds in the field. So, some of the preventive cultural practices. So, even the preventive cultural practices say enu antandre, yavade vandu crop na grow madakattiri antandre, athwa crop na healthy agi idbeku antandre, vandishtu conditions now follow madbeku. So, we have to quarantine the plants before sowing the plants in the crop field, or before sowing the seeds in a crop field, we have to quarantine them. And the cultural techniques such as the crop sanitation. ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಇವಾಗ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಾಪನ್ನು ಗ್ರೋ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಬಿಫೋರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದ ಕ್ಲೀನಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ನೆಸೆಸರಿ, ಆರ್ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಸ್ಯಾನಿಟೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ನೆಸೆಸರಿ. ಬೈ ರಿಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ದ diseased plants and cleaning some of the weeds present in a crop, or the crops which spread infection to the other crops. So these are some of the measures we have to do while culturing the plants or while sowing the seeds in a field. So preventive cultural practices are nothing but it is best for local growing conditions and maintaining healthy crops. Then third method, that is monitoring. So this is the third principle involved in a IPM. So regular observation is necessary in the integrated pest management. So if we are growing the crops, the regular observation of these crops is necessary in the insect pest management. The observation is, or observation can be done by two steps. Those are inspection and the identification. So inspection can be done by the visual inspection, by observing the insects or spore traps and some of the other methods like inspecting the monitoring tools and etc. And identification is nothing but we have to identify the pest which is causing damage to the crop field, and also we have to identify the host plant and their pathogen. So in this way we can control the pest population by observing the crop at regular intervals. Through the clear inspection and identification, we can control the pest population in a crop field. So monitoring is necessary. This monitoring can be done at a regular interval through visual inspection or through the identification of the pest which is causing damage to the crop field. Then fourth process, that is the fourth principle, that is mechanical controls. So these mechanical controls are nothing but a use of some of the methods or a simple techniques can be used in order to eradicate these or in order to reduce the population of the insect pest. So if a pest reach the unacceptable level in a crop field, so then to reduce these pest population in a crop field, these mechanical control methods will be applied or used. So when a pest, yavaga pest enu antandre control aglard condition alli reach agutta avage enu antandre first method yavadu use martara antandre ee vandu mechanical control ana use martara. Through these mechanical control, in these mechanical control we use simple hand picking, insect barriers, traps, vacuuming and tillage. So these are some of the mechanical controls used in a pest control method. So if pest reach a unacceptable level or beyond the control level, if the pest reaches, then we have to use these mechanical control to reduce the population of the insect pest. Then fifth principle, that is biological controls. A natural biological process or a materials can provide control with the minimal environmental impact, often at a lower cost. So even the biological control alli enu antandre, to the implementation of the natural biological process or a natural method ana use madibittu enu antandre aa ondu insect population ana kadme maadabodu. Matte enu antane, these biological control measure are cost will be low if we use these biological controls in an insect pest eradication. So if we are implementing these biological control method in a field, it will be a costless or a lower cost. So through the use of the natural biological process or materials, we can control the insect pest and also the minimal environmental impact. So ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಏನು ಅಂತಲೇ ಬಯಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಯಾವುದೇ ಥರ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟಿಗೆ ಹಾಳಾಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಥವಾ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟಿಗೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಥರದ್ದು ಇಂಪ್ಯಾಕ್ಟನ್ನ ನಾವು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಮಾಡೋಂಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಮತ್ತೇನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಏನು ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಈ ಒಂದು ಬಯಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಮೆಥಡನ್ನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ. ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಯೂಸ್ಫುಲ್ in insect pest control method. So these biological control method will be used in an IPM. Then the main focus of these biological control is to promote the beneficial insect that eat or parasitize the targeted pests. So even the biological control method alli en martara antandre ಒಂದೊಂದಿಷ್ಟು ಬೆನಿಫಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತವೆ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ಲಿ. ಆ ಒಂದು ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸನ್ನು ಗ್ರೋತ್ನ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಪ್ರಮೋಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಇನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಬಯಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಮೆಥಡ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರಮೋಟ್ ದ ಬೆನಿಫಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಸಿಟೈಸ್ ದ ಟಾರ್ಗೆಟೆಡ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇರುವಂಥ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ಸನ್ನು ಗ್ರೋತ್ನ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಪ್ರಮೋಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಎನಿಮೀಸ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಪೆಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಪೆಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ biological insecticide derived from naturally occurring microorganisms. So in this biological control they will use some of the biological insecticide where the naturally occurring microorganisms are play a major role in this biological insecticide. Those are BT, that is Bacillus thuringiensis, and some of the fungi and nematodes. These are some of the biological insecticide are the natural enemies which are used in these biological control method. So the sixth principle that is used in a IPM, that is responsible pesticide use. Synthetic pesticides are used as required and often only at specific times in a pest life cycle. So these responsible pesticide use, so only the pesticides will be used in a specific times of the pest life cycle. So at a particular time, that too during the particular pest life cycle, these pesticide or synthetic pesticides will be used to kill the pests or to reduce the population of the pests. Then the use of low volume spray equipments reduces the overall pesticide use and the labor cost. So ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟಾಗಿ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಪೆಸ್ಟಿಸೈಡ್ಸನ್ನು ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಓನ್ಲಿ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅಪ್ಲೈಡ್ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಸೈಕಲ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ದೀಸ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟಿಸೈಡ್ಸ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ in a low volume spray equipments and it will reduces the overall pesticide use and also the labor cost. So even though pesticide in a use maadthivi andrunu enu andre at a specific time alli adu yavaga andre particular pest life cycle time alli enu antane ಈ ಒಂದು ಪೆಸ್ಟಿಸೈಡನ್ನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ಕೂಡ ಏನು ಅಂತಾರೆ ಲೋ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಏನಂತ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ತ್ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಐ ಪಿ ಎಂ. Then why these IPM is oftenly used? So IPM, it is used oftenly to control the pest population, and these IPM are use of these pest control actions, that is the use of these IPM method, it will ensure favorable economic, ecological and sociological consequences. And also these IPM, it will be applicable to the agricultural, horticultural and many public health purpose. So in these way, these IPM will be used in many fields. And these IPM, it relies on the knowledge, experience, observation and integration of multiple techniques. So these IPM, it will be perfect for the organic farming. So due to the different property of these IPM, it will be favorable to the economic, ecological, sociological consequences. And also these IPM will be used in different purpose, that too in agricultural, horticultural fields. And these IPM, it always relies on the knowledge, experience, observation and integration of the multiple techniques. So due to this property, these IPM is oftenly used in nowadays. And for large scale farms, these IPM is convenient. And this IPM, it will reduce the environmental pollution. As if we use the pesticide more without implementation of these IPM in an agricultural field, it will cause damage to the environment, as these pesticides are formed from the hazardous chemicals. So they will release some of the harmful chemicals to the environment. So through the implementation of these IPM, we can reduce the cause done by these pesticides. So these IPM is more helpful to the humans and also to the environment. Without the knowledge of IPM, we may pollute the environment, also may harm the health of the organisms. So in this way, these IPM is more useful to the mankind. And these IPM include many techniques so that we can reduce the population of the insect pest and also reduce the cause or damage caused by these insect pest. Then steps in integrated pest management. So what are the steps involved in this integrated pest management? First one, proper identification of the pest. So ivagenu yade vandi integrated pest management alli iruvanta methods, maybe natural control agirbodu athwa applied control agirbodu, yade vandu method na implement maarti ond crop field alli antane, we should know the pest which is causing damage to the particular crop. So proper identification of the pest is necessary in the IPM. Then learn pest and host life cycle and biology. So after identification of the pest, we should learn about the pest life cycle and also the host life cycle and the biology involved in these pest and host or interaction between the host and pest should be studied. Third one, that is monitor or sample environment for pest population. Is the pest present or absent? So in antane we have to monitor the pest population. So whether the pest is present in the crop field or absent in the crop field, whether the pest population is increasing or decreasing, or how these pests are affecting the crop. So these are all the things we have to monitor. So this is the third step, that is monitoring the pest population. Then fourth one, establish action threshold. So how these pests are causing damage to the crop field. So we have to establish some of the actions to reduce the pest population and causes of these pest to the health or to the economy. So as establish action threshold, it is necessary step in the IPM. How these pests are causing damage to the economic or health. So up to what level these pests are acting in a crop field. So we have to establish the action threshold. Then fifth point, that is use resources to keep up to date on IPM developments. Keeping up to date gives you the best options available to when using IPM. So up to date information regarding the pest population, pest life cycle, and about these things should be up to date, so that we should implement a correct method in a pest control. So use resources to keep up to date on IPM developments. How these IPM can be used to reduce the population. So in this way, through using the resources to keep an eye on the IPM developments. So this is the fifth step, that is use resources to keep up to date on IPM developments. Then sixth point, that is choose an appropriate combination of management tricks. So if we are in this IPM, the management of tactics is necessary to control the pest population. So we have to choose wisely which management tactic is more effective in a pest control method. So these tactics include mechanical or physical control, cultural control or biological control, or they may be the chemical control. These are some of the tactics that are oftenly used in a IPM to control the pest population. So we have to choose the appropriate combination of the management tactics. So through you choosing the correct management tactic, we can eradicate these insect pests from the crop field. So this is the sixth step, that is choose an appropriate combination of management tactics. Then seventh one, that is evaluate result. This is the process to review an IPM program, and the result is generated Understanding the effectiveness of the IPM program allows the site manager to make modifications to the IPM plan prior to pests reaching the action threshold and requiring action again. So, ಇವಾಗ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಫೀಲ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಐ ಪಿ ಎಮ್ಮನ್ನು ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಅದರದ್ದು ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಏನು ಬಂದದ ಅಂತ ಇವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯುವೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದೇನು ಅಂದರೆ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಐ ಪಿ ಎಮ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟೆಡ್ ದ ಐ ಪಿ ಎಮ್ ಆರ್ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್, ಅಪ್ ಟು ವಿಚ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಐ ಪಿ ಎಮ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ field, what are the effect it shown in a crop field against these pests. So to evaluate these result, so this is the important step, that is evaluation of the result. So up to which level this IPM has worked in controlling the pest population will be done through the evaluating the result. So these are the steps involved in a integrated pest management. So ಇಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೆ ಏನು ನೋಡಿದ್ವಿ, ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್, what are the principle involved in this pest management and steps in the IPM. Thank you.